Hi everyone, I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. In this video, I want to show you how to convert a Fat32 volume to an NTFS volume without removing the data from the volume. You might need to do this because Fat32 has many limitations. So the limitations of Fat32 very quickly are, first, you cannot copy a file that is larger than 4 gigabytes to a Fat32 partition. Then the Fat32 partition maximum size is 2 terabytes. The third one is that Fat32 file system doesn't have a journaling capability. This means that it is not as reliable as NTFS volumes. And the fourth one is that you cannot put security on a Fat32 volume. So for instance, you cannot protect it with BitLocker, and you cannot put also NTFS security on it. So to make the conversion, it is very easy. I'm gonna demonstrate this on a USB key that I have on my system. So I'm gonna switch to screen recording. Here in my example, I'm using Windows 11, but the information I'm gonna show you applies also to other Windows versions. The first thing you need to do is to open File Explorer and then click on this PC. And under this PC, you need to identify the drive letter of the USB key. So here it is G. So this is the USB key I want to convert. Let's see its properties. And you notice that it is FAT32. So I'm gonna cancel here. And now to perform the conversion, you need to open a command prompt. So click on the search box and type in cmd and hit enter. So the command prompt will open. Let me minimize this and bring it to the middle. So let me clear the screen first. And this is the command that you need to key in so that to convert the volume. Convert space. You need to specify the volume here. So it is the G column space slash fs for file system column NTFS, so to specify that we need the volume to be NTFS, space, slash X. So the slash X parameter is to kill any process that is using the volume so that you can log the volume and convert it. Slash V for verbose so that you can see all the information in front of you. And hit enter. So now it is converting the file system as you see, and it shouldn't take long. And chances are that at the end of the conversion, you're gonna receive always this data error cyclic redundancy check. This is not a big deal. Here's what you need to do in order to make sure that the volume is correct. First, let's check the volume if it was converted. So in File Explorer always under this PC. So this is the volume that we needed to convert. Right click on it, properties, and you see that it is NTFS now. So this way we converted the volume without losing the data on it. So it still has all the data in it. So now we need to check the volume because we received this error. And this is how you do it. So key in chkdsk always in the same command prompt slash F to fix, and then specify what disk you want to check. So here it is G column and press enter. And this command will perform a chkdsk on the volume and it will correct it in case it needs correction. So now the volume is corrected and it is converted to NTFS. Now, sometimes, unfortunately, you might receive an error like this one. It says cannot create the elementary file system structures. And this is a random error. So I did some troubleshooting and this is what I found useful that you can perform. First, you can check disk the USB key or the volume with the check disk command that I just showed you. And the second solution I found is that if I deleted some files and folders from the volume, the conversion command will work. Now I know that this goes against what I said in the beginning, that the conversion will be performed without losing any data on the USB key. But unfortunately, this is the only solution I found next to the check disk of the USB key. I also tried third-party applications and also they didn't work. Now, the drastic measure is, of course, to copy all the files to another storage device and then reformat the volume with NTFS and recopy the data. But this is a solution that is not a direct conversion. If you have a solution to this error or any other error that the convert command might produce, please put them in the comment section below. This will help everyone that is watching this video. I want to thank you all for watching, and I hope that this video was useful to you. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this will help my channel greatly. And this way, you'll not miss my future videos. See you on the next video.